Mayor Lori Lightfoot says the restaurant industry is suffering, but she won't fight the ban. She talked with Governor Pritzker today for about an hour.
We had a very frank productive conversation, and we've committed to make sure that we continue to work together. No, I'm not filing a legal challenge, and obviously we've been working in partnership with the state from the very beginning, and we're going to continue to do that.
The decision is a blow to businesses hoping to profit off Halloween. CBS 2's Stephen Graves live in Little Italy. Stephen, owners tell you they're frankly scared.
Yeah, Brad, scared for the future of business, obviously, and the financial woes. Here on Taylor Street in Little Italy, I'm told that trick-or-treaters come out filled with families. But this year, even if the crowds do come, there won't be any business. Little Joe's Bar had big plans for a happy Halloween.
$4 well cocktails and our $3 domestic, some fun Halloween-themed specialty shots.
The spooky decorations are out. Kids who see them from outside marvel as workers usually hand them candy.
So this is hard, no doubt, and we are a bit heartbroken.
Sweet treats now sit on bar tables for customers. The liquor all stocked up and ready to go, but most of it won't be sold.
But those things will be available until close of business tomorrow.
They've made the call to close because of barely any warm outdoor seating. It comes as Governor J.B. Pritzker orders bars and restaurants across the state to stop indoor service Friday. The governor blaming rising COVID-19 cases. Today, Chicago seeing a 7.6 positivity rate. Last week, it was 6.1. While some suburban businesses are defying the governor's order, this Chicago bar doesn't plan to shake things up.
Frankly, you know, after being shut down or only to go cocktails, we just don't have the revenue to pay these fines, to fight these battles in court.
This is horrible. It's a tragedy.
Across the street, Tuscany Restaurant is now pivoting sales strategies, selling items half price. The group that owns it took conference calls for hours today, trying to figure out next steps at 7 restaurants.
Some that were, you know, potentially going to be closing for good come Monday.
8 others were already closed.
And so we were barely surviving. We cut our losses the past couple months, and that was during the summer months.
And the Illinois Restaurant Association have started this sort of online initiative. They are asking people to email the governor and General Assembly in opposition to this move. They say if restaurants are closed, that will drive people to have more private gatherings that are uncontrolled. They say furthering the spread. Live here in Little Italy, Stephen Graves, CBS 2 News.
COVID-19 rules changing by the day. Keep up on top of the latest restrictions by downloading our new CBS Chicago app.